And Selin Nakapolu, feminist and advocate. Welcome to you both, ladies. Hilal, to you first. This convention, in theory, it helps protect women from domestic violence. So what would be the rationale of the Turkish government to withdraw from such an agreement?
I mean, I believe that men who commit femicides should be executed. But feminists disagree with me on that. Does that make feminists less concerned about femicides than me? No. This is a difference of methods. Methods of how to confront violence against women. And also, it should be noted that the Istanbul Convention is not a holy text that all states should undersign. And for instance, the US, Canada, Britain, they did not undersign it. And France and Germany, they also put their reservations on this convention. There are two basic objections. First of all, the convention brings about a quite radical practice to confront violence, but the definition of violence is quite ambiguous. For instance, violence is divided into four categories. It's not only physical violence, economic violence, sexual violence, and psychological violence. And if a woman feels she did not suffer from any of these categories of violence, but if she feels that she might suffer from these categories of violence, she can call the police, and the police will take the man in question, usually the husband, away from home for at least 3 months, sometimes 6 months or more. So the man is taken away from home by police force if the woman feels that she might suffer from violence. And also, the general outlook of the convention also doesn't fit with the Turkish public as well. For instance, if a husband shouts at his wife who is cheating on him, and if he says bad words to her, this can also be considered as a crime under this convention, and this man who has just been cheated on can also be taken away from his home. And also, if a mother or father prohibits their teenage daughter to have premarital sex, again, under this convention, this is also considered as a crime, and that the state should take measures against it.
You mentioned there, you know, Turkey was the first country to sign up for this, and it's been in place for a long time. What's changed that this needs to now be withdrawn?
Well, what looks good on paper may not always be good in reality. After Turkey signed this convention, there also came about a law that is still in place, by the way. I think Ms. Nakipoğlu should know as a lawyer. The law that came with this convention is still in place. With the practice of this law, the practices that came about with it caused an uproar in public. Men being slandered, taken away from their home and from their kids without showing any evidence of violence, by the way. And also the rise of the LGBT discourse in Turkey, because as you know, the convention brings about a feminist queer lexicon that forces the term sexual orientation to be a legitimate definition and all the connotations that come with it. And it also defines the word honor as a so-called phenomenon. Now, for one, I am against any violence committed in the name of honor, such as we see in honor killings. But if you negate the importance of the value of the word honor, then I cannot accept that. Because honor as a word, as a phenomenon, and also marriage as an institution is important for Turks. But as feminists see these two things as a way of enslaving women, and that these things should be destroyed according to them in order to emancipate women, there are some irreconcilable differences between Turkish people's understanding of their way of life